हमारे बीच में वो पधारने वाले हैं। माननीय गृह मंत्री श्री राजनाथ सिंह जी का, माननीय आज के इस कार्यक्रम में हम सभी आपका हार्दिक अभिनंदन करते हैं, हम स्वागत करते हैं। माननीय डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन, मिनिस्टर ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एंड अर्थ साइंसेस, माननीय श्री अनिल माधव दवे, मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट इंडिपेंडेंट चार्ज फॉर एनवायरनमेंट फॉरेस्ट्स एंड क्लाइमेट चेंज, माननीय गृह राज्य मंत्री श्री किरेन रिजिजू का हृदय से अभिनंदन करते हैं, रिस्पेक्टेड डॉक्टर पी के मिश्रा, एडिशनल प्रिंसिपल सेक्रेटरी टू प्राइम मिनिस्टर, होम सेक्रेटरी श्री राजीव महर्षि का स्वागत है, श्री आर के जैन मेंबर एनडीएमए तथा श्री विपिन मलिक एडिशनल सेक्रेटरी डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ होम अफेयर्स का। सभागृह में पधारे माननीय केंद्रीय मंत्रीगण तथा विभिन्न राज्यों केंद्र शासित प्रदेशों से पधारे राज्य के माननीय मंत्रियों का भी हम हार्दिक अभिनंदन करते हैं। नेशनल प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर डिजास्टर रिस्क रिडक्शन NPDRR की दूसरी मीटिंग में सभी महानुभावों और सम्माननीय मेहमानों का हम हार्दिक अभिनंदन करते हैं। दो दिन की ये मीटिंग एक ऐसा प्लेटफॉर्म है जहां सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, पार्लियामेंटेरियंस, लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट्स, मीडिया, इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, NGOs, लोकल कम्युनिटी रिप्रेजेंटेटिव्स, साइंटिफिक और एकेडमिक इंस्टीट्यूशंस तथा कॉरपोरेट बिजनेसेस यानी विभिन्न क्षेत्रों के प्रतिनिधि अपने विचारों, अपने अनुभवों का आदान प्रदान करेंगे। आपसी सहयोग से नए नए अवसरों को एक्सप्लोर करेंगे। हमारे यहाँ कहते हैं कि समुद्र मंथन से अमृत की प्राप्ति हुई थी। निश्चित ही दो दिन के इस मंथन से डिजास्टर रिस्क रिडक्शन की दिशा में भविष्य की योजनाएं बनाने में हमें मदद मिलेगी। किसी भी शुभ कार्य के प्रारंभ में दीप प्रज्वलन की परिपाटी रही है। हम माननीय गृह मंत्री श्री राजनाथ सिंह जी से अनुनय करते हैं कि कृपया मणिदीप को प्रज्वलित करके कार्यक्रम की विधिवत शुरुआत करें। मंच पर पधारे माननीय सम्माननीय अतिथिगण से भी हम निवेदन करते हैं कि कृपया इस शुभ कार्य में वे भी सम्मिलित हों। दीप प्रज्वलन से कहते हैं कि ऊपर वाले का आशीर्वाद और अपनों की शुभकामनाएं साथ जुड़ जाती हैं, माहौल ईश्वरीय हो जाता है, रूहानी हो जाता है। धन्यवाद माननीय। अब हम श्री आर के जैन मेंबर एनडीएमए से आग्रह करते हैं कि कृपया सभी के स्वागत में अपने उद्गार व्यक्त करें।
ऑनरेबल Union Home Minister and Chairman of the National Platform for Disaster Risk Reduction, Shri Rajnath Singh Ji, Honorable Minister for Science and Technology and Earth Sciences, Dr. Harshvardhan Ji, Honorable Minister of State for Home Affairs, Shri Kiran Rijiju Ji, Honorable Ministers in Charge of Disaster Management from various state governments, Honorable Members of Parliament, Additional Principal Secretary to Honorable Prime Minister Dr. P.K. Mishra, Home Secretary Shri Rajiv Maharshi, other distinguished delegates, guests, friends from media, ladies and gentlemen. It's my great pleasure and honor to welcome you all in the second session of the National Platform for Disaster Risk Reduction. As we all know, that any amount of efforts in disaster risk reduction is incomplete without the involvement of all stakeholders. Accordingly, National Platform was created to provide a forum for consultation and discussion among the stakeholders and to evolve a participatory process of decision making in the field of disaster management. The members of the National Platform include Honorable Ministers of select ministries of Government of India, honorable ministers from states dealing with disaster management, honorable members of parliament, both from Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, secretaries and senior officers of Government of India, representatives of local self-government, mayors, chairpersons of urban local bodies, representatives of Panchayati Raj institutions, disaster management experts, NGOs, INGOs, civil society organizations, experts from academic institutions and institutions of national importance, representatives from media, etc. It is in this background that a two-day program has been designed to discuss important issues of disaster management. The outcome of this event will be presented in the global platform on disaster risk reduction during the last week of this month. This is the second meeting of the national platform on DRR. The first one was held in 2013. During that period, Hyogo framework for action was under implementation. During these 4 years since we've held the last session of DRR, a lot has happened in the field of disaster risk reduction, both at the global level as well as at the national level. Now we have new framework for action, that is Sendai framework for disaster risk reduction, with a long-term mandate up to 2030. India, along with other 186 nations, voluntarily committed to this Sendai framework in 2015. This is the first national platform after Sendai declaration, and hence the discussion needs to be centered around Sendai framework. Secondly, we have a 10-point agenda outlined by our Honorable Prime Minister during the Asian Ministerial Conference for Disaster Risk Reduction. Our future roadmap has to integrate these two. Last year, we released our first National Disaster Management Plan and became the first country in the world to align our national plan with the priorities of Sendai framework. Our national plan has been appreciated by many, including by UNISDR. There are many firsts done by Government of India. India has successfully conducted the first ever joint exercise of SAARC nations, where members of the response teams of all SAARC nations jointly responded to the simulated situations of disasters. We hosted the first post-Sendai Asian Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction in November last year, with a record participation of more than 4,000 participants. We also organized BRICS Ministerial Conference on Disaster Management last year. India's role after the 2015 Nepal earthquake, not only in response and relief, but also in reconstruction, has made India the largest external donor for Nepal recovery. India also provided relief support to other nations affected by disasters, including Fiji, Ecuador, and Sri Lanka. India has very recently, as we all are aware, launched SAARC satellite, which will help this region to manage disasters more effectively. We are also planning to organize a joint exercise of BIMSTEC countries during the current year. Friends, we have all the three essentials for DRR in place now: the legal framework, the institutions, and the national plan. Our response capabilities and early warning capabilities have improved remarkably. The state governments are taking special interest in disaster risk reduction. Many states have set up state disaster response force. Many SDMAs have emerged as champions in their respective states. All these states and almost all districts have disaster management plans. Some states have also prepared roadmaps for DRR based on Sendai framework. In short, this national platform is held from a higher plane when we compare it to the previous one. We are not talking about reducing disaster losses now, but the discussion is on reducing disaster risk. Friends, we have designed this two-day program in such a manner that we take maximum advantage of the presence of all of you to discuss critical issues and to provide suggestions towards making India a disaster resilient country. There are ministerial sessions where honorable ministers from states will make statements about their plans and strategies. There are plenary sessions and technical sessions to cover the four priorities of Sendai framework. As a prelude to this event, both the NDMA and NIDM have conducted more than a dozen pre-events in different parts of the country in partnership with the state governments and other stakeholders on various themes of disaster risk reduction, covering response, mitigation, planning for DRR, civil society participation, heatwave management, training and capacity building, hospital management, risk resilient infrastructure. Outcome of these pre-events will be presented later today. As a part of NPDRR, an opportunity has also been provided for startups to display their products and the state governments to disseminate their initiatives to a wider group of people who are into managing disaster risk. This would help knowledge sharing and exchange of best practices among the participants. As the time is short, I would not like to go in further details. Friends, our Honorable Home Minister is a very busy person. Despite his pressing engagement and urgent work, he has kindly consented to inaugurate the event and address us. I welcome him on behalf of all of you. I also welcome Honorable Minister for Science and Technology, Dr. Harshvardhan, who provided support for DRR activities and guidance whenever we approached him. I also welcome Honorable Minister of State for Home Affairs, Shri Kiran Rijuju ji, who is giving continuous support for all our efforts in disaster risk reduction. I may mention here that he has been designated as the Asian champion in DRR by the UN. Special welcome to honorable ministers who come from different states to take part in this event. I also welcome honorable MPs to this event. Special welcome to Dr. P.K. Mishra, whose relentless support has helped us to move on the part of DRR. And Home Secretary Shri Rajiv Maharshi, who has been guiding all the three institutions, NDMA, NDRF, and NIDM on a continuous basis. I welcome all the participants, speakers, chairs, co-chairs for their participation and commitment for DRR. With these words, I once again extend a very warm welcome to all of you. Thank you and Jai Hind.
धन्यवाद श्री आर के जैन. माननीय गृह राज्य मंत्री श्री किरेन रिजिजू को डिजास्टर रिस्क रिडक्शन चैंपियन ऑफ द एशिया रीजन के अवार्ड से सम्मानित किया गया है. आप एक चिंतनशील और जागरूक राजनीतिक व्यक्तित्व हैं. हमारा आपसे अनुरोध है माननीय कि कृपया हम सभी को आज के इस शुभ दिन संबोधित करें.
आदरणीय श्री राजनाथ सिंह जी, भारत सरकार के गृह मंत्री, आदरणीय डॉक्टर हर्षवर्धन जी, साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी मंत्री भारत सरकार, और विभिन्न राज्यों से आए हुए मंत्रीगण, प्रिंसिपल एडिशनल प्रिंसिपल सेक्रेटरी टू द प्राइम मिनिस्टर डॉक्टर पी के मिश्रा जी, Home Secretary Rajiv Maharshi ji, members of the NDMA, senior officials representing various states, ladies and gentlemen, media friends. We are having this meeting, this very important gathering, after two important events which took place. The 2015 Third World Conference in Sendai to adopt a framework for disaster risk management, disaster risk reduction for the whole world with a target set up till 2030. Then last year in 2016, in the month of November, we had a successful Asian Ministerial Conference held at New Delhi, and the conference was inaugurated by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji. During that conference, we have set the goal, the action plan to take forward the framework adopted in Sendai Declaration. In the Asian Minister Conference, Prime Minister had laid 10 agenda points for us to tag along. I just want to point out the agenda number one. The Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji said, we must ensure that all development projects, airports, schools, bridges, and all the development projects are built to appropriate disaster resilient standards and contribute to the resilience of communities they seek to serve. Build a coalition to support disaster resilient infrastructure. I feel this is the foundation of the entire approach, because unless we integrate disaster risk management into the whole developmental approach, we may not be able to achieve the desired target which we want to set our society as a safe society, as a secure society. How do we create a resilient society? We have set agendas at the global level, at the national level, at the regional level, and at the local level. In the last 3 years, I have personally experienced that India has taken a lead role. I must take this opportunity to mention here that the Prime Minister has given us a new dimension, a new impetus. And I'm proud that India is taking a lead role in the entire efforts of disaster risk management, especially in the South Asian regions. Our member NDMA had explained the various steps which we have taken. We have drawn lots of inspiration from the Honorable Prime Minister, and we are one of the first nation to come out with a national disaster management plan. The international bodies have complimented India for that, and we have a very driving Prime Minister office. Dr. P.K. Mishra ji is here. He is personally giving touch with all efforts. That is how we see the active Prime Minister's office involved in the whole effort. And in the Home Ministry, under the able leadership of Honorable Home Minister Rajnath Singh ji, the entire Home Ministry is gearing up to ensure that we are standing in all occasions whenever there is required of any kind of role from our side. I must compliment the officers in the Home Ministry, led by Rajiv Maharishi ji, all the members of NDMA, NIDM, and all the stakeholders. We have a very efficient team. That is why we could hold this wonderful event. And I'm sure that when the states make their presentation of the respective states, then we will come out with better ideas. I have personally visited some of the states. I really appreciate the way in which many of the states have progressed in the last few years. They have strengthened their capacities. The special dedicated teams are being formed. The SDRF are being formed in most of the states. And disaster plans are on place. I have got opportunities to interact with many of the stakeholders, many of the local communities also, the international agencies working in India to support and strengthen our efforts. It is very pertinent for India to be prepared. We can't afford to lose, because India is one of the most disaster-prone regions in the world and one of the most populated regions in the world. We are bound to face disaster in the coming years. If not by the natural disasters, then definitely by the man-made disasters. We must be prepared. And I'm very glad that I got this opportunity to work with many of the organizations in India. I want to stress that the time of simply disaster management is gone. It is the understanding of the risk which is being framed in the Sendai Declaration. That understanding the risk, strengthening the risk management, the investment in disaster resilience, and to strengthen the capacity. These are the hallmarks of the successful dealing with any disaster challenge in the future. And I said in the beginning that unless we integrate the whole developmental agendas with understanding the disaster risk, then only we can create a safe and secure society. I don't want to take much time because I will be with you again tomorrow in the closing ceremony where I will be making certain remarks of my experience and the outcome of this event. The Honorable Home Minister is here. He's going to make the statement. I wish the 2 days conference a success, and I once again extend my heartfelt welcome to all the representatives from the states to participate in this event. Thank you so much. Jai Hind.
धन्यवाद माननीय. विविधताओं से भरे भारत में भौगोलिक विविधताएं भी हैं और इसीलिए प्राकृतिक आपदाओं की आशंकाएं भी विभिन्न हैं. हर क्षेत्र में, हर मौसम में, हर इमारत में हिफाजत हो, चाहे वो स्कूल हो या अस्पताल, फायर और इमरजेंसी सर्विसेज हो या सिविल डिफेंस, या फिर सैटेलाइट से पूर्व सूचना. हम पूरी तरह से मुस्तैद तो हैं, पर अब सभी स्टेक होल्डर से लेकर सिविल सोसाइटी तक को मिलकर, जुटकर पूरे के पूरे इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर को डिजास्टर रेजिलिएंट बनाना होगा. आइए देखते हैं इस बारे में एक फिल्म.
India's stunning geographical diversity includes the majestic Himalayas, fast-moving rivers and waterfalls, rich and verdant forests, a long coastline, and shifting sand dunes. At the same time, growth in population, unplanned urbanization, structural frailties, and the geoclimatic conditions have made India susceptible to all kinds of disasters. According to the Global Assessment Report 2015 of UNISDR, India is the third most disaster-prone country in the world.
So based on this reality, we are making ourselves strong enough to respond to any kind of disaster which strikes our country every now and then. For that, we have geared up from the grassroots level to the policy level. And we are happy that the international community is recognizing India as a champion country in terms of our response.
To reduce the impact of disasters and to encourage all stakeholders to participate in reducing risks, rigorous training programs are being undertaken at the national, state, and district level. To strengthen preparedness, community-based disaster risk management programs, regular exercises and mock drills are being conducted in remote and high-risk areas across the country. Schools and hospitals are being retrofitted and evacuation plans are being put in place. Programs like the National Cyclone Risk Mitigation Project, School Safety Program, strengthening of fire and emergency services, and revamping of civil defense are being implemented to build capacities and make infrastructure disaster resilient. The effort is to make disaster management everybody's business.
There is a clear need to move away from managing disasters to building resilience. And that requires working with all parts of society, the government, the private sector, the civil society organizations, the academic institutions. And this work has to be done across sectors. In urban development, in water resources management, in agriculture, in education, in health systems. Only then we will be able to position disaster risk management as a core development issue.
The paradigm shift in India's approach to disaster took place after the 2001 giant Gujarat earthquake that caused immense loss of lives and property. The efforts towards reconstruction are worthy of emulation.
The Gujarat earthquake reconstruction program has been one of the most influential post-disaster recovery initiative in recent times. It has served as a model for other disasters. A legal framework in terms of the Gujarat State Disaster Management Act was the first in the country. There was also a new and effective institutional structure. All these influenced our efforts at the national level and also at the international level.
In the year 2003, the National Institute of Disaster Management was formed. 2005 was the watershed year. It saw the adoption of the Yoga Framework for Action, the promulgation of the Disaster Management Act, and the setting up of the National Disaster Management Authority.
There are three things that NDMA primarily does, which is to provide guidelines, policies, and plans. So we've issued guidelines on different disasters. We have a policy on disaster management. And recently, we come out with National Disaster Management Plan. We also have come out with templates for preparation of state-level plans, district-level plans, preparation of disaster management plans by different departments of Government of India.
In 2006, the National Disaster Response Force, NDRF, was constituted. Its 12 battalions, strategically stationed across the country, respond speedily to natural as well as human-induced disasters. India's disaster response and early warning system complements its rapid advance in ICT, the state-of-art satellite technology, radar technology, supercomputers, and remote sensing techniques for weather forecasting enable dissemination of information in real time. India took a leadership role in the region by organizing the first South Asian Annual Disaster Management Exercise, SADMEX, in 2015 for over 80 disaster managers from SAARC countries. The BRICS Conference on Disaster Management was hosted in Udaipur in August 2016. To give shape to the implementation and monitoring of the Sendai framework in Asia, the Asian Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction was organized in Delhi in November 2016. Committed to enhance international and regional cooperation, India launched the South Asia Satellite on the 5th of May 2017. It will provide communication, disaster support, and connectivity in the region.
This is first of its kind project in South Asia. And to this project, Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, Maldives, Nepal, Sri Lanka, and India will together achieve better governance, more predictable weather forecasting, and efficient resource mapping, linking people with top and medical services through telemedicine and a quick response to natural disasters.
From Fukushima to Fiji, India has responded with speed to help other countries in the time of disaster. India's response to the earthquake in Nepal is an example of regional cooperation in disaster rescue and relief. Managing disasters is now necessarily a collaborative exercise. The time has come for all stakeholders, from government to civil society, to join hands and work together to build a resilient India. Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi has a vision to energize India's efforts in disaster risk reduction.
Let me outline a 10-point agenda for renewing our efforts toward disaster risk reduction.
All development sectors must imbibe the principles of disaster risk management. The Housing for All in Smart Cities program generates new knowledge opportunities for hazard risk assessment and for integrating disaster-resilient technologies to reduce risks. Work towards risk coverage for all, from poor households to SMEs, multinational corporations to nation states. Financial inclusion, particularly the Jan Dhan Yojana, Suraksha Bima Yojana and the Fasal Bima Yojana, is a step in this direction. Encourage greater involvement and leadership of women in disaster risk management. Women need to be trained as volunteers, engineers, masons, and building artisans to support reconstruction and in livelihood recovery. Invest in risk mapping globally. Zones prone to risks and hazards need to be accurately mapped. Leverage technology to enhance the efficiency of disaster risk management efforts. An e-platform should be developed to facilitate exchange of ideas, expertise, technology, and resources to maximize India's